This is another demo of the Linux for Network Engineers series. On this demo, we'll talk again about interface information. This is the part two. In the previous week, we had the part one, and let me jump into it. So on this, we're going to be talking about the difference between ifconfig and the ip command. In the last live demo, we talked about how to check the status of network interface by using the ifconfig command. So I'm gonna type it here again. So you type ifconfig and you get the status of the different interface available on this machine. So ifconfig has been around for many years, and actually it's getting obsolete and deprecated. And its place is taking another command, which is called IP, okay? And the corresponding command of the IP type that shows the list of network interfaces is IP link show. So here you see the same three interfaces that are on this machine, and it displays another, I would say, wealth of information around those interfaces. So let's examine one by one, right? What's going on here? I'm going to clear this just to show only the things we need to look at right now. So I'm going to show IP link show WLAN 0. I'm sorry. Okay, so here it is, right? So now, of course, this is the name of the interface, and now I tried to dig into and find out as much information I could about the different keywords that are being displayed here, right? So let's go through them one by one and see what they mean, right? So now the first thing it tells us is that this interface is a broadcast interface, which of course means that it has a valid broadcast address, right? And then it tells it supports multicast, as you can see here, okay? And then the up keyword here tells that the interface is running, okay? Not necessarily connected to the network, but is running. And lower up now, it tells us that actually there is a signal at the physical level. So something is plugged into the network interface, okay? So up is more like the interface available, and lower up means that the interface is actually there's something plugged in, there's a cable, Ethernet cable plugged in, right? And we'll see though in contrast how this looks like later on when that not there's nothing plugged into the interface. Now what do we get next? The maximum transfer unit of this interface, 1500. The queuing discipline for this interface, which is a P54 fast. Now the state of the interface, which is up. So now I looked into that, and this it seems like it overlaps what lower up means here, okay? But I'm not sure why they have both the lower up and the state up information to different points here. It looks redundant. I don't know if there's a case where these maybe have different values, okay? Now I haven't been able to find out what is the mode and group information here. I looked around, but I couldn't find out. And then finally gives us what is the queue length that is being used in this interface. On the second line now, we see that this is an Ethernet interface. This is its MAC address, and this is its broadcast address, right? So this is how the WLAN interface looks on this machine, which is actually interface that is working and is currently connected to the network. Now let's clear this. And in contrast, let's see how the interface ETH 0 looks like. Actually, on purpose, I didn't plug this interface in. Okay, so here we see that it says no carrier, which means that actually there is no signal detected on the physical interface, right? So it's not connected. Also set up for broadcast, can support multicast, and up means that the physical interface is running, right? So that means more that it's there, the drivers are working and all these things, right? But it's not, there's nothing plugged into it as is being shown by the no carrier keyword here. Again, this is similar information, MTU1500, queuing discipline P5 for fast. And then here again, the state is down, right? So again, this looks redundant since we know from here that there's no carrier, so there's nothing connected to it. So I'm not sure again why they overlap, and the rest of the information is similar to the previous interface, the WLAN 0, right? In terms of queuing length and MAC address and broadcast address. Now let's take a last look at the loopback interface. Okay, so of course this tells us here that this is a loopback interface. It's up, it's there, it's working, right? The MTU is the maximum 65,536 bytes. There is no queue here, so there's no physical interface, and the state is unknown. So this is now in the previous interface that were physical, there was a state up and state down, right? Here it says unknown because there's no physical interface, right? It tells us also it's a loopback interface with, of course, empty MAC address. So now, as I said, the app IP command is here to replace the ifconfig set of commands. And you can do pretty much everything you can do with the ifconfig command. So you can write commands such as IP link set ETH 0 down to take down an interface, or up to bring it back up. Okay. So there are similar sets of commands for between the ifconfig family of commands and IP. I would recommend you that moving forward, if you are new to Linux, to start using the IP set of commands. If you have been around for a while and used Linux before, I'm sure ifconfig is the default command you type when you're going to look at the state of the host interface. That's what I do actually as well. I'm trying to switch right now, but it's not easy. But it's much more powerful, has many more details and about the interface state, and ifconfig eventually will go away in our lifetime, so it's better to switch to this new set of interface management and information gathering commands. That's it for today. Thanks so much, and see you at another Linux Framework Engineers live demo.